Funny, men also buy lingerie. So, well, we are focused on women, but yeah, men also are a sizable.
What percentage of men come to your site to buy versus look? Let's start with that, right?
We don't, yeah, so we don't, like, it's the same thing like what Deep was saying. And Kunal was speaking about the half that works and the half that does not work in terms of marketing spend. So we decided not to spend on men. So yeah, but there are men who come and, you know, spend a lot of time on the site. All right. Hello everyone. Hope you have had a wonderful evening so far. It's very difficult to talk about lingerie because most of the attention is usually concentrated around the visuals. So this time I've tried to keep it at a minimum, and I hope I'm not disappointing people. So, you know, as a retailer, we would think that if we have the right product, if we have the right price, and we have the right experience, we're pretty much there. And it's just all about these three things. Right. Now, I want to draw a parallel out here as to how men buy. Most product pages selling to men usually have, you know, the name, the price, the size, and the buy now button. It's possibly a web designer's nightmare because there is so little information. So is it really that men buy with this much of minimal information? The decision tree looks pretty simple. Is it cool? If it is cool, is it expensive? How expensive is it? Some men will actually consider size, okay? And some men will possibly go beyond saying, will it attract my wife or my girlfriend? And that is pretty much out there. And consider a sales is made when three out of these four are actually yes, right? But, you know, when it comes to women, it's really a very, very different thing. So, you know, incidentally, this t-shirt, if you see, is one of the best-selling t-shirts on a global t-shirt website, and this is called Beatles Walk Across the Road. But I'm not sure how many women in this room would find this t-shirt pretty interesting. So anyway, now when it comes to women, these four things possibly will become maybe 10 or more, right? So as a retailer, you would think, okay, as long as I can answer to these queries, I've pretty much got the woman consumer out here. But the problem is that is not how women logically think. So this logical tree that we were talking about is actually a jungle out there, and the woman pretty much traverses through this jungle very rapidly in her mind. And that pace could be few minutes or few hours or few days. So when selling to women consumers, it's extremely important to answer these questions in a manner that the target consumer can understand. We realize this and continue to realize many more such decision choices that women make. And therefore, our product pages go through a continuous stage of evolution. We try to answer each and every possible question in the woman's mind before she can make the purchase decision or before she can go out of that particular page. It can be simple basics like what is my delivery timeline, is there a return policy, or it can be beyond basics to understand about the fabric, to understand about what it will do to my body, to understand a fitter's note, and also if, you know, can I send a hint to my husband and ask him if he likes it or does not like it. So this is what we have, you know, this is what we've done for every product on our website. And this produces the finest, and this is what we feel, that this produces the finest decision engines built for women in the manner that they think. From the decision tree that women are having, then retailers need to go a step beyond. How do I make the product that I retail very relevant to the woman customer? As an example, you know, beauty comes in all shapes and sizes, and you know, women are definitely aspirational when it comes to buying products, but that is not the only reason that women buy. For any retailer selling to women, it's important to know who they are, what is their size, what is their life stage, what is the occasion that they are buying for, right? And then, amongst everything else in the crowd, women will associate only when they feel that the product is relevant to them. It's her in the crowd that the product is speaking to. And as a retailer, that is not a simple problem to solve. So what we did, understanding relevancy as a concept, what we did is we delved deeper into assortment. We ensured that we have the widest and the deepest assortment coupled with availability. We ensured that we spoke to a real person all the time, culling out negative words like fat, busty, thin, and you know, you're replacing it with full figure, curvy, petite, and I think adding it with a whole lot of filters, segmentation, such as when a woman, let's say, comes to buy a sports bra, you know, we say that, okay, if you want to buy a sports bra, what kind of activity do you do? What kind of body shape do you have? Is it low impact, medium impact, high impact activity that you're looking at? And that is where the product, each product on a site becomes relevant to each consumer who's looking for a particular answer in her mind. So this is possibly, you know, as soon as you start becoming relevant to a consumer segment, every retailer wants to become the BFF, for men in the room, it's best friends forever for the target consumer. But becoming also this, while this is a, you know, sounds easy, again, this is a process, it's a journey to get there in the woman's mind. How do we do that? So to become the BFF, it's a conversation that we need to have, and we do that through several touch points on our site where we have conversations not only about order details or delivery, but we have conversations around fit, about what are the lingerie solutions that they're looking for. When we get that opportunity to take it into a little more than conversation, we grab the opportunity of consultation. And that is where we start talking to the consumer and start building what they call is lingerie awareness. As we start stacking the consumer in the ladder of consultation, we realize that now a woman who has come to the site has gotten more information than she previously had. And we know that after this, it's just a period of some time where a woman will actually become a buyer on the site. After consultation, we've built our positioning on the consultative framework for the last 2 years, but now we want to take it to the next level. The next level is the level of advocacy. When you create the demand, the right demand for every consumer group who is coming to the site, and this is something that we are now trying, that how can we start getting onto a position of advocacy for our consumers, which means can we suggest them what is the swimwear that they need to wear, or what is the party wear that they need to wear, or what is the bridal look that they need to be having. So, you know, this is possibly the last slide. So we're doing this because, we don't want to challenge ourselves in understanding the complex, head of a woman. But I think we're doing this because the offline buying behavior, the offline buying environment for lingerie is grappling with social embarrassment, pushy sales rep, if they're not all men, unavailability, low assortment. So what we are basically trying out here is, can we make the entire experience of something as basic and as personal and intimate a product like lingerie convenient, discreet, private, and joyful for the woman customer in India? We have a big team of consultants who help women every day find the right size, find the right fit, and so that women go back happier. It's a change in buying behavior. Women have always bought lingerie for, let's say, 10 years, 20 years in a certain way, and we are expecting them to change. And this change can only happen when you understand what goes into their minds very well. So thank you all. And I just would like to, thank Kalari, who believed in us, who believed in the opportunity that, Zivame had, and who supported us all along in these 2 years, and we do hope we have their support in the next years too.